Uh-huh. We have made it. Okay, so the title of this video should be Ricky Radness has a new address for his mental facility, and hopefully it will change to a better facility fairly soon. But currently, please write to Ricky Beachum, B-A-C-H-U-M, space, 39-1, at Post Office Box. Feel like the card. 4030, in Petersburg, Petersburg, Virginia, 23803. Yeah, definitely please write. He'll appreciate it. You got all kinds of fun news and sad news and everything else. So, like, it seems like he's looking at 5+ years right now. And if so, it would be extremely wonderful if he could go to Eastern State Mental Hospital to elsewhere in Virginia. Doesn't feel backwards. Huh. But it is. Left hand. Huh. All right. In other news. Well, no, still on Ricky for a second. He can receive things at the post office box. They obviously can't be contraband, etc., etc., etc. And so, Eastern State Mental Hospital was formed in 1773 as the first public lunatic asylum. Pretty cool. It's a whole different campus now, but it still looks like they kept up to it. It was interesting when I was looking it up, they mentioned Dr. Galt, and I knew that Dr. Galt was some innovator who kept his job, but was a little poo-pooed by the establishment for his ethics and morality were, like, way above the standard, well below par, shooting eagles and holes in one. So then they had a history on him, of course, and that was really nice. The Eastern State, which hopefully he does get to go to, has 317 patients and 900 staff. So that's a pretty good ratio. And many other things about the place. You can look it up. It's pretty cool. Did a FOIA. No, I didn't do the FOIA. Somebody else did a FOIA. FOIA, and that was enlightening and encouraging. Okay, me. What happened first? My keyboard died. the numbers are backlit and the letters are backlit. So I could sit in the dark with just the computer on and type. And so that went first. Then my camera died. And then my vaporizer caught fire. And then my mower, my riding mower. I already have one riding mower that had a severely bent axle. And then I bought another one, and it broke a spindle at all four bolts. So I had to get that off and replace that. And I didn't tighten it down enough. It was great fun though, because my brother helped me, and but we didn't have enough weight to tighten that on appropriately, so I had to have someone come and fix that right quick. And then he went ahead and took my other mower and fixed that on the cheap. These are both $2,000 mowers, so they're like, paying $200 to get $2,000 back is pretty good. What else broke? Oh, and then my weed whacker broke. I had a spare weed whacker, but I haven't used it for 2 years. And the gas tank had a crack in it, so it was leaking, which was annoying, because you can't really go using a weed whacker leaking gas on lawns. I had two, maybe three clients die because I just never heard from the other one again. They were my primary source of income. And my blower still worked. quit drinking beer. Had DTs real bad for like a week or week and a half. Not every day, but you get them one day and then bang, there's no stopping the shaking. But that's a good thing. I'm much more clear-headed now. I was having panic and anxiety attacks. Panic being I wanted to run away anywhere, and anxiety being I just wanted to hide in my room, which is fine when you have a dog, but it's not so fine when you can't run away because you got $2 and change to your pocket. And then getting another push mower fixed. That's my dad's. That doesn't really involve me. My push mower works. Yeah, as long as I don't let anybody else use my equipment, it seems to work fine. As soon as other people think that they can use it, things happen. I don't have my whackers back yet, though, which is getting to be a little old. So this is your, August update. I have a birthday at the end of the month. Woohoo! Mars should be visible quite clearly late at night. Like during the night. I don't know when it stops being visible after midnight. Well, I'm gonna sneeze. Excuse me. But that's always just been a part of my nighttime watching at night. A lot of times there's a blue moon in August. which is also cool. Scarf was up on the bed.
Yes, you.
I don't know if I can get it that far. Can you see me? Anyway. So,
there you are. Come on. Come on.
I didn't turn it off yet.
So it was interesting having two computers going on at the same time yesterday. Getting all these notifications from all these companies. Where are you? You're over there now. Okay. And security alert, another device has been accessing your information. I'm like, I know, I'm the one doing it. And so I now have a little bit larger computer. The other computer, the problem was it had 21 gigabytes. And all but two of them were used up somehow. And I've gone through and I erased pretty much everything in there, but they're just like all the operating programs took up a whole lot of memory, so there was never any memory for me to, like, I couldn't load Word. I couldn't have Word on my computer, which is horrible because, you know, I use these real keyboards so I can type, and anybody that remembers Flying Axe know that I like to translate the Bible and to modern English using ancient techniques, their forms of grammar, and then read them. But so I haven't done that for years now. 4 years? 5 years? However long it's been. Been here for 6 years. Boy, time flies. And it's so pretty. Yes, yes.
And you can't get away with not talking like a baby. Or a child, I guess. I don't see Goo Goo Gaga. My freezer is still almost completely full of meat, so there's at least 6 months of food in there. And I keep finding really good deals, so that works out really good since I have. It's like I have a perpetual $2. Which is plenty when stuff only costs $1.78. It also means I can't buy beer because the beer costs more than $2. So that's a good thing. If you have not, if I turn it that way, then you can read it forwards. You thought I wasn't clever.
if I can get that Scott Burson and Jerry Walls on there. Seems to be a little bit more difficult. So anyway, if you can, you should pick up the book. That's what I got for the moment. Cherishes and new love.
Be well. And yes, I keep my camera covered.